Hello everyone and welcome to Moonlight Jewel. My name is Elisa and today I'm going to make a special doll for Easter so that you have something to watch during your Easter. Of course I could have made a bunny doll or a little chick doll this year, but I wanted to be a bit more unconventional. When I talked to a friend, we finally came up with the idea, a Gudetama inspired doll. For all of you who don't know Gudetama, it's a lazy egg mascot by Sanrio, the same company who invented, for example, Hello Kitty, My Little Twin Stars and My Melody and much more. Gudetama is basically an egg and is always tired, always lazy, and I think very relatable and adorable. So, of course, there are endless possibilities to make a Gudetama-inspired doll. I wanted to go for a very cute look. Easter is all about pastels and cute colors, so I thought a doll with yellow skin, like Gudetama, dressed in Lolita with a Gudetama-inspired dress print would be amazing. The perfect candidate this time was Luna Matthews. She has the perfect skin color and a super cute face. As always, I'm removing her face with acetone and cut off her hair and remove her antlers. I'm getting rid of the hair inside her head by removing her head and pulling out all of the chunky glued hair. Then I'm starting to root her with Milky Blonde Canicalon hair by Retro Dolls US. The hair is beautiful, but it was so lightweight that I had single hairs flying around everywhere. After the reroot is done, I already separate her pigtails and the bangs area and tame it down with boiling water for cutting and styling later. Then I pack her into a piece of fabric and begin with the face up. I gotta say, I struggled a lot this time. I wanted to give her those tired, drippy eyes and slightly open mouth. I begin with giving her a lot of super cute blushing and start defining her lips already a bit. Then I go in with white acrylics and define her lips a bit more by using oranges, yellows and red. Since Gudetama is very simple designed, I wanted to keep her face up kind of simple too. Now, her eyes were the part where the struggle began. I sketched down the shape and thought it was pretty okay, so I sprayed it with MSC and added the eye whites. But after I had lunch, I realized they didn't look sleepy enough. But I already sprayed on MSC, so I couldn't erase it anymore. I then took some white acrylic paint and brushed over a thin layer of paint, trying to correct the eye shape, and then just gave her some orange-yellow eyeshadow. It was a struggle. After a lot of swearing, I eventually got it in the end, and now she looks super cute and sleepy already. I'm giving her brown eyes and draw her lashes, but this time I draw them downwards so that she looks kind of tired. I finished the face with pearly shimmers, gloss on her lips, and add some highlights in her eyes too. Yay, the face is done! For her little Lolita outfit, I'm going to make a dress with a self-made Gudetama pattern, a petticoat, a little blouse, and we'll give her a cute headdress, some repainted shoes, and a bacon blanket, since you can see Gudetama quite often covering itself with a bacon as a blanket. For her jumper dress, I'm making a print first and iron it on the fabric. I made a separate video on the print, so go check that out if you're interested how I'm doing that. Then I'm sewing down the seam of the skirt, add a glue-on lace and gather it. For the top of the skirt, I'm sewing the front and back pieces together and add lace too. Now I can attach the gathered skirt to the top, close it in the back and add some straps of lace, Velcro and some ribbons to finish it up. The petticoat is made from some lace layered with striped fabric, sewn together in the back and finished up with an elastic waistband. For the blouse, I'm gluing down the seams of the collar first, attach it to the bodice, hem and gather the sleeves and sew them to the bodice too, close the side seams and add Velcro in the back too. For the blanket, I'm taking a rectangle piece of baby pink fleece fabric with round ends and clean up the seams with a wool thread. Then I'm cutting out some bacon-like shapes of reddish and cream-colored crafting felt and glue them onto the blanket. Her shoes are some Draculaura heels I just painted in matching colors. Thank you. For a headdress, I'm making some bunny ears and a little gudetama of polymer clay. By the way, with some rubbing alcohol, you can remove specks of dust from polymer clay quite well. I had to paint the yellow a bit darker after baking because I didn't have the right color. Then I'm just giving gudetama a face and gloss it with gloss varnish. And I'm taking a monster high headband and paint it pink and hot glue all of the accessories I wanted to have on it. Now we need to style her hair. I'm curling it with straws and dunk them into hot water. On the next day, I'm removing the curlers and we have some beautiful fluffy curls. Now I'm already putting her into her outfit, give her headband, and place the headband on her head. and we're done. Wait, where's our Gudetama doll? I said to her, the filming and the photoshoot will be today. Honey, do you know where she could be? Of course, she was sleeping under her blanket. Sleepy you. I think she came out very, very cute. How do you like her? Please let me know in the comments below. And if you liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for some future custom fun. And here's a shout out to all of my patrons. Thank you so much for supporting me and being part of the work in progress on this doll. Thank you so much for watching and happy Easter! Bye!
Boah, ich krieg'n Rappel.